Welcome to ETF.com University, where we demystify the world of ETFs. My name is Dave Noddick, Managing Director at ETF.com, and welcome to our last video on understanding some of the tools we have at ETF.com to help you analyze ETFs. Now, if you haven't seen the videos we've done on due diligence and efficiency and tradability, I recommend you go back and watch them before moving forward. They're the first three in this little mini series within our broader education videos. Today, we're going to be looking at what we call fit. Well, what does that mean? Well, if efficiency answers the question, does this fund do what it promises? And tradability answers the question, can you access it? Fit is where you ask the question, is this actually the right fund for my portfolio? After all, a sector ETF that's tracking tech stocks might be a great fund, but if what you're trying to do is generate a steady dividend stream, it could be a terrible fund for you. A core principle when looking at funds is to put them in the context of what you're trying to achieve. So when you look at the fit section of any given ETF, you'll see all these statistics, and they compare the fund to a segment benchmark. And that benchmark is chosen by our data provider, in this case, FactSet. And it's generally the most boring index that they can find tracking a given investment objective. So, for example, if you're looking at funds that choose stocks from the global equity market, well, the segment benchmark is the MSCI All Country World Index, including all of the investable stocks, including frontier markets. We then measure every fund in that segment against this neutral, somewhat boring benchmark. Funds are then scored based on how much like that naive benchmark they are. So a score of 100 means that an ETF essentially is the benchmark, and a score of 10 would mean that the fund is making some very significant bets to be different from the benchmark. Now, importantly, that's not necessarily a good thing or a bad thing. You might be looking for really plain vanilla exposure, or you might be looking for something that's very different. So let's head over to the fit section of some fund reports at ETF.com, and I'll show you what we mean. When you go into any ETF fund report on ETF.com, you're going to be met with this screen. And the overview tab is just what it says, a quick overview of the fund in English. And if you click over to the fit tab, you'll be brought here. The first thing you'll see is this sector and industry breakdown. And this is where you can see how that fund stacks up against its segment benchmark. In this case, we're comparing the S&P 500 Spider ETF SPY to the MSCI USA Large Cap Index. Now, SPY matches up pretty well here, but not completely. It's a little overweight in utilities and basic materials and financials. It's a little underweight in healthcare and tech. So it's not perfect, but it's pretty tight. So SPY has a high fit score of 97. Now you can also see how this fund compares to the segment benchmark using traditional regression statistics over here. You can see that the beta here is pretty much spot on. It's going to move just like the index. And you can also see that all the country weights are pretty much perfect as well. And if you're wondering why SPY might not be completely perfect, if you look down here, you can see some of these portfolio statistics that explain it. The S&P 500 turns out to include quite a few mid-cap stocks, making the fund slightly lower average market cap than the benchmark. And that's probably why it's scoring a 97 here and not 100. Let's compare that to a fund that is using the exact same 500 stocks, but weights them differently. So this is the Invesco S&P 500 Equal Weight ETF, RSP. And you can see that this fund doesn't score nearly as well. And even a quick look at the sector breakdown will show you why. Just by changing the weighting scheme, RSP is now significantly overweight financials and consumer stocks and industrials, and it's dramatically underweight technology and healthcare. Now, this shouldn't be too big a surprise. After all, we're cutting the weight of those huge FANG stocks down just to, you know, less than 0.25% each. We can also see that this fund will be lower beta. It moves a little bit less than the broad market. And if you scroll down, you can also see we're pretty mid-cap here. Now, none of this makes this a bad fund. It simply makes it different. So it's worth reiterating that sometimes you might want to be different. Consider, for example, smart beta funds. they intentionally tilt towards certain factors. So let's look at the Invesco FTSE RAFI Emerging Markets ETF. This is PXH. Now, this is a fund that says right up front, it's taking the emerging markets and it's picking stocks based on fundamentals. So you wouldn't expect it to look like the whole broad market, but the fit section shows you how it's different. So you can see here that this take on emerging markets goes heavy on Brazil and Russia. And down here, you can see it's heavy on energy and financials, but it skips a lot of technology companies. And if you were leery of emerging tech, maybe this is the perfect fund for you. Before we move on, I want to point out two tools you might miss that I think are really interesting, and we're going to cover them in their own videos in the future, but you should at least know where they are. Let's go back to SPY here. And if you go down in the FIT section, you'll see this block on ESG. Now, this comes from our friends at MSCI, and this uses their environmental, social, and governance methodology to effectively rate the holdings of SPY in this case and compare how ESG-ish this fund is versus, you know, other competitive funds you might look at. And you can see a few things here. First, you'll see BBB. It's like a bond rating. And as you might expect, triple B is pretty average. And if you look at its peer group ranking, which is a 58, that means that SPY is just a little above average in its ESG-ness versus comparable funds. And last, I want to go back up to the overview section and point out a new addition we've made to the site. For all equity ETFs, you can now find the MSCI factor box. Now, this is MSCI's analysis of the factor bets every equity ETF is making versus a broad benchmark. So it's not comparing it to the segment benchmark, it's comparing it to the broad market. We'll cover this in detail in a future video, but even a quick glance here when you're looking at an equity fund can help you figure out what kind of factor bets a fund might be making. Is it betting on low volatility stocks? Is it betting on value stocks? Is it focusing on high dividend yielding stocks? We'll be expanding this tool in the future to make it even more useful, but I think even at its most basic, it provides another interesting lens on any given ETF. I hope you found this brief walkthrough helpful, and I hope you'll join us for the rest of the series.